In this vlog, we would like to deal with the implementation of Flutter file upload. So basically, in our previous tutorial, we have seen with the implementation of file download in your Flutter application, where we have tried to download a sample file. So that is the text document file which we have tried to download in our previous tutorial with the help of a DO library. And now in this part of the tutorial, let's try to upload the file. And now this time we will try to upload an image file, and we will be fetching this particular image file from your device itself, and also we'll try to manage the permissions as well. So in the previous tutorial, I have said you right to make use of the permissions to download the file onto your Flutter application onto your device. So in this part of the tutorial, let's try to implement the Flutter file upload, that is image upload, to the server. And we are also using a real-time API here. We are not using any dummy API to show you the status code or what is the response we are getting, but this time we are trying to see a real API where we are trying to upload an image, and I will also show you the image after it has been uploaded. So here we are making use of a third party tool, and that third party tool will provide us an API. And whenever you are trying to implement this particular tutorial, try to replace the API with your own API so that the tutorial works in a similar way for you as well. So there is no change in the logic, only you can try to change the key name which were provided in your API. So now let's get started with this particular tutorial and try to see the implementation. We have already added the required library, that is DO library, to our Flutter project, so we need not add anything new now. Let's try to use the same code which we were using for our previous tutorials as well. So if you have not gone through our previous tutorial on Flutter download, that is downloading a file using DO library, I suggest you to please go through it before getting started with this particular tutorial, so that it will be very much helpful for you to understand this particular concept. So now the very first thing we'll start with here is, like, instead of download, let's try to provide here upload. So instead of download, let's try to provide upload. But one thing, do we have any upload option here? Let's try to see. So we don't have any upload API request here. Then how we can upload our image or whatever the file it might be? Yes, generally how you will try to create some resource in your server will be making use of a post API request, right? So here in this part of this tutorial, we have discussed in detail, like, what is a post API request and how do we implement it in our Flutter application. So yes, in this part of the tutorial also, for uploading an image, we are going to make use of a post API request only. So there is no separate API request called upload. For download, it is a separate API request is there, but for uploading a file, we are making use of post itself. Okay, so here let us provide the API. So what is the API here? The API which we are going to use is IMBB. So here I would like to show you the website for it. So this is the IMBB. This is a third party website which we are going to use for this particular tutorial. And I also suggest you to go through their terms of services before using this particular service. And also make sure you follow these particular rules and try to follow them before making use of their services. So just go through this particular terms and services, and if you like it, then start using this particular service. So currently I have just created the account, so I don't have any images or albums here. I don't have any followers, or I'm not following anyone. So this is a brand new account. So just for tutorial purpose, I have created this particular account. So creation of an account is very simple, and if you are having any queries, just do let me know in the comment section below. And now let's try to upload our image to this particular server here. And in the about section, so when you tap on about here, you are having these particular options in the drop down. and tap on the API here, the key here. So with the help of this particular key, you need to upload your data. Yes, this key plays a very important role, and without this particular key here, you cannot upload your data to this particular website. And here is the upload API here. So upload API and upload key here. These two are the primary things here. And if you want to add a new key, you can just tap on this particular button and you can delete it respectively. Okay. So let's try to see the parameters now. What are the required parameters? As I have said, key is the required parameter, and image, of course, this is what we are going to upload here. And yes, only images we can upload using this particular service. So I have said we are trying to upload an image to the server. So in the previous tutorial, we have clearly seen how we can pick an image from your device here. If you are having any queries in picking up the image, I suggest you to go through this particular tutorial so that you will get a very good knowledge on how you can pick an image from your device and provide that image over here. And name, again, it's an optional thing. If you have provided the name, it's well and good, or else it will consider the name based upon the file path you have provided. And expiration. So here, expiration is like the time duration till which you want the file to be present on their servers. And again, this is also an optional thing. If you want, you can just specify them, or else you can just skip it. And this is how the API response will be. So whenever you try to provide, whenever you try to make use of this particular API call, you will be getting a response which looks similar to this one. Okay. So this is so simple and easy to understand API implementation. And if you are still having any queries in understanding any of these things, just let me know, or just follow this tutorial till the end. Don't skip any part of the tutorial to avoid any confusion. So now let's get started. So the first thing here is like copy this particular API here and try to paste it over here. And yes, we have got the API. Then what about the data? In the post API request, we have data, right? And in data, how we should send our image, key, and also the name if required. So how we will be sending all these three things here? Have they specified anything here? So if you clearly observe here, in the name here, the name of the file, this is automatically detected if uploading a file with post and multi-part by form data. So they have specified, like whenever you are trying to make use of a post or multi-part or form data. So generally I have explained you regarding the multi-part data, uploading the data using multi-part here in this particular vlog. And whenever we are trying to upload a data here, we will make use of this particular multi-part scenario where so the data is being divided into different parts and then it is being uploaded rather than uploading the data completely at once. Okay. So now let's try to make use of the form data here. And with the help of the form data, we will try to provide our image, key name, our key, and also the name here. So let us specify form data here. Here you can see we have got form data dot from map, and within the map we need to provide the key value pairs here. So the first thing we are going to pass is like a key here, and let us try to specify the key. And the second thing we are going to pass is image here, and let's try to provide the key here. And don't worry about the order we are trying to provide here. You can just provide image first, key next, and all these things, but I'm just trying to go with the proper flow, so I'm providing in this particular way. And again, name is an optional field. If you provide, it's well and good, and if you don't provide also, there is no error. So this particular image, from where we are getting? So let's specify await, and we have discussed, right, multi-part. So let's try to make use of it, multi-part file dot from file, and here we need to specify the file path and also the file name here. For now, let us try to specify file name to be file name only, and later we'll try to provide these two fields. And let's try to remove this particular line directory here, because this one we have used in our previous tutorial where we try to download a text file. So here this is our form data, and try to add this over here. So the data here is nothing but the form data which we are trying to send, that is which we are trying to post with the help of our API here. And now let us try to fetch the onSend progress, like how much of data is being sent. And also you can make use of onReceive progress in terms of whenever you are downloading a file. So in our previous tutorial, try to implement onReceive progress. And if you are having any queries, just let me know in the comment section below. So here, let's try to specify onSend progress. So here we'll be getting two parameters, like one is sent here and other is total. So how much is the total size of the particular file and how much is being sent? So based on these two things, you can just calculate and provide a UI for the user so that he can understand like how much data is being sent and how much is remaining. So here I'm just trying to print the sent and total here, and also let's try to enclose them into a single quote here and provide a semicolon. So here I'm just trying to print them using a print statement, but in real time you can just make use of it according to your requirement. So now let's get back, and what is file path and what is file name here. And for this again we will try to refer our previous tutorial here where we have made use of a file picker. And let's try to make use of a file picker here. File picker result, specify an object like result await file picker dot platform dot what we are having option here, pick files. Okay, so we are trying to pick a file, right? And in our previous tutorial I have also clearly explained you how to provide the restrictions over here. So if you have not covered that particular tutorial, in this way we can just provide the restrictions, like specify the type here. So just go through that particular tutorial and try to find out how we can just restrict the data according to the type which we have required. So let's try to validate the result, and if result not equal to null, and inside which we need to process the result accordingly. So let's specify file here, and we are trying to fetch the result into this particular file, result.files.single.path. And if this is empty, then let's try to specify an empty double quotes here so that we don't get any error if it is null. And also try to enclose this within the file here and provide a semicolon here. And now let's try to fetch. And now let's try to fetch file name here. So how we'll be getting a file name now? So consider the file dot path dot and split here. So in the path here, it will be separated by this forward slash. So let us try to split with the help of this particular forward slash and try to fetch the last one here. So the last one will be having the file name. So in this way we are trying to fetch the file name, and here you can see this is what the file name which we are going to use here. And yes, form data and the API call should also be inside the if condition here. So I'm just trying to remove the closing bracket here and trying to provide it over here. And also if there is if condition, we also need to provide an else condition, such that if the condition which we have specified, that is if result is double equal to null, then let's try to handle that particular scenario as well. Result is null. And again, these are all the basic statements which I am providing here. Just replace it with your required functionality, okay? So yes, we have got the file name here, and here we need to have the file path now. So file path is nothing but you can just create a variable like string file path equal to file dot path here, okay? And you can just make use of it over here. Or you can just directly add file.path over here. Anything you can do here. And now we have specified almost all the things, and here let's try to specify some name. Finally, we need to specify the key over here. So I'm providing my key here, and now let's try to run this particular code and see the output once, whether this works properly or not. And here we have got the output, and still we are having download file because we are making use of our previous tutorial code. And let's try to change it to upload file and rerun it. And now let's try to tap on upload file. And here, as we have installed the application, it is not asking us permission again, but it will ask you the permission if you are trying to make use of it for the first time. So I will try to remove the permission and try to show you again here. So the files and media permission is allowed here. So I'm selecting don't allow. And now try to open our application here and tap on download file here. So here you can see it is asking us the permission to access the photo and media on our device. So whenever you tap on allow here, it is showing the images which are present in your device. So let's tap on this particular image and now try to observe the output here. Here you can see we have got one image now, and this is what the image just we have tried to send. So when you try to upload this particular image here, clearly you can see like on send progress. So this is what the on send progress which we have tried to print over here, and also this is the response now. So the ID for the image which we have uploaded, and here you can see we have got the title to be A here. And whenever you tap on this particular here URL, so this is the display URL, we were being diverted to the web page, that is the page where our image is being stored. So this is the path and it is showing us. And also you can clearly see that the name is a bit different. Okay, the name which we have provided here is being considered and not the name which we have provided specifically here. Just we'll be skipping this particular name and try to rerun this particular code and check whether this works properly or not. So yes, even if we don't provide the name, as we have seen, like it's an optional parameter only. So we have tried to upload this multiple times. Let us try to see whether it is been uploaded multiple times. No, it is only uploaded once only. So here you can see it is not uploading the duplicate images, but it is maintaining the same image. Let's try to delete it and try to re-upload it. So let's try to upload here itself and try to see. Let's try to refresh the view, and again we have got one image now. So tap on this particular image, and this time we have got image 2022, and this is what the name which we are having in our device. Okay, so I think this is very much clear for you, and I hope you understood this particular tutorial. And if still you are having any queries, just let me know in the comment section below, and the code for this tutorial is provided in the description section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.